and thank you for joining me today to learn about RBC Express's file transfer. In this video, we'll be taking a look at how to upload a file to RBC. RBC Express File Transfer is a gateway where you can upload files created by your third-party software to RBC. There are two main types of files that can be uploaded here. Check files are uploaded by clients who have signed up for Payee Match, which is a check fraud mitigation tool. ACH payment files are uploaded by clients who are enrolled for the ACH payment services. ACH stands for Automated Clearinghouse, and ACH payment files can be one of two different types. PAP stands for Pre-Authorized Payments. This is for collecting incoming payments for the purposes of rent, leases, fees and dues, or tuition. PDB or PDS refers to direct deposits, which you may also know as EFT payments. This type is for outgoing payments, such as payroll, or for paying vendors and suppliers. To upload using file transfer, go to the blue banner at the top of your screen and select Payments, Transfers, and Deposits. Under the File Transfer heading, select Upload. This will present you with an option to search or browse in your computer for your file. Once the file has been located and selected, enter your password, the same one that you use to sign into RBC Express, and your token, which is a small device which displays a 6-digit passcode. If you have any questions about how and when to use your token, you can view our administration video on tokens. What happens next depends on your organization's approval rules. The rules are created by the administrators of your profile, and they outline whether users can upload files independently or if they need approval from others. There is also an administrative video that demonstrates how to set up these rules. To approve a file uploaded by another user, go to the Payments, Transfers, and Deposits tab and select Approve under the File Transfer heading. Here you will see a summary of the file details. On the far right, you can click on the icon to see the full file. To approve the file, use the checkbox on the left and select the blue Approve button at the bottom. Then, enter your password and token. Now that we have covered the types of payments that can be uploaded and how to upload and approve a file, the rest of this video will focus on the format and confirmation reports of the ACH payment files. In order to upload an ACH payment file, your third-party accounting software will need to be able to create the file in one of the three acceptable formats. The three formats are CPA 005, ACH American Standard, and RBC Standard. You can access the file format specifications from the File Transfer User Guide. Also, when you are new to file transfer, you will be referred to the RBC testing team, who will help you take your prepared file and do a test upload before you send live payments. If you are using File Transfer to upload ACH payment files, it's important to read and save your confirmation reports. A report will be available once a file has been uploaded and, if necessary, approved. The reports generate into the ACH menu under Service Reports and Data Files. The report itself is called an Input, Verification, and Edit Report. This report confirms that we have received your file, and it will flag any issues that may prevent RBC from processing the payments within the file. Here we have an example of a good report. On the top left is your organization's name and client number. Your software may refer to this number as your originator ID. On the top right is the 4-digit file creation number and file creation date. The report contains a list of transaction statuses. This is where we can see how many payments were in the file and the total dollar amount. This section is also where potential issues will get flagged. You'll notice transactions held for correction, or T errors, which is what will happen if there is an individual payment within the file that cannot be processed. You'll also notice transactions blocked, which you will see if the whole file cannot be processed. Here's an example of an input, verification, and edit report with errors. Near the top of the report will be the reason for the error, and this will tell you whether it is a single transaction being held or the whole file that has been blocked. If your file has been blocked, in addition to the error on this report, your profile's registered contacts will receive a courtesy email to which they can respond to have the file unblocked or deleted. If you have a single transaction being held for correction, that can be addressed directly within the RBC Express platform by using the ACH Payment Manager. The Payment Manager will be visible on the left-hand side of the ACH menu, just above the Service Reports options. To modify or delete a T error or other future dated payments, you will be using the Inquire/Modify feature. For more information on modifying or deleting payments, we recommend that you watch the ACH Payment Manager video. And for additional resources, such as the file formats or how to address potential blocked files, please review the file transfer guide within the RBC Express Digital Training Center. If you have any questions about the features shown in this video, you can always contact the Client Support Center. Our phone number is at the bottom of your screen at all times.